Hey, what's up, everyone? Ryan here, and I'm back with another NHL 24 Be a Pro Career Mode Series video. And I know it's been a couple weeks since the last episode, but I wanted to post the final episode today. Yes, this is the series finale of the Ryan Gamer NHL 24 series. This series has been so much fun. The next game, NHL 25, is set to release into early access, I believe, on September 27th. So about a week after this video goes live, a little bit less than a week. So I have not decided on a new series for the new game yet. I want to know your all's input. Do you all want to see a new series for NHL 25? I would love to do one playing for my favorite team in real life, the Pittsburgh Penguins. I think that would be a lot of fun if we just go straight into the NHL, skip past the prospect stuff, go straight to the NHL, and start with the Penguins. I think that would be a lot of fun. But this series has been so much fun, and thank you all so much for all the support on this series. This series has brought so many good laughs, so much fun, and Ryan Gamer is set to close out this career mode series with a big time game. It's our final game here of season one here, Ryan Gamer's rookie season. Now, when I simulated this season, Chicago Blackhawks played pretty good, right? So Chicago, right now through 81 games, has a record of 37-40-4. Still ranked 28th in the NHL, so we definitely did not make the playoffs. But Ryan Gamer is the favorite to win Rookie of the Year. So you can see at the top right, Ryan Gamer in 81 games played has 77 points, 33 goes, 44 assists. We will be reviewing Ryan Gamer's other stats at the end of this episode. We'll take a look at his career stats here at NHL 24. And I want to know how many fights we had. I'm interested to see that. How many penalty minutes we had. And also our shooting percentage is probably not going to be very high. So we'll see if we led our team in hits, assists. So I do think that Ryan Gamer led this team in points. But we will see all that at the end of this video. So, if you want to see a series for NHL 25, let me know in a comment down below. I am undecided. I just don't know. I don't know. It might be like NBA to where I take off a year and do an NHL series the next year. But honestly, this series was so much fun. It would be hard to not do a new series for the new game. But I have not decided yet. My most requested series on the channel is FIFA. So I would like to do a series for the new FIFA game. It might have already started by the time this video goes live. So that's on the plans. It's always my most requested career mode series here on the channel is FIFA. So we may do that one, and who knows, we might still do an NHL 25 series. If not on this channel, maybe we do it on the second channel. But big thank you again to all of you all for all the support on this series. And if you get some enjoyment on this video, be sure to drop a like. It really helps the channel. Subscribe for more, and there is plenty of other career mode content here on the Gamerability YouTube channel. We got 9 ongoing series at the same time. It may be 10 or 11 by the time next week rolls around, if I decide to do a new series for both the new FIFA game and NHL. I'm undecided. We will see how that turns out. But we get to close out this season, unfortunately, not in front of our home fans in Chicago. We will be in LA facing off against the Kings. And this is a battle for 27th place. That's right. If we win, we are moved to 27th place and take LA Kings spot. So kind of a big game in a way to close out this season, right? I don't know about all that, but I want to get in 3 fights in today's episode. 3 fights. That's right. And let's score a hat trick too. Let's put hat trick first, 3 fights second. It is time. Series finale here in NHL 24. Ryan Gamer, the best fighter in NHL, the most penalty minutes in the NHL. He did not mess around, a true enforcer.
Hi everybody, welcome back to EA Sports. I'm James Cebulski. Well, we know they're not playoff bound, but it's a final chance to say goodbye for the fans tonight here on the ice.
Final goodbye, everybody.
Well, we've been waiting for this one all day long, and here we go.
Come on. I'm so fired up. I always get so fired up for NHL.
LA's caught it along the wall.
Is that it? Did we just steal it and then give it away, but then our teammate grabbed it?
Drives to the paint. LA's got control of the puck. And now they look to make something happen from the neutral zone.
Yes.
He got all of that hit on the play.
Some players get into the game by physically engaging early. There's a fine line there, but that was executed perfectly.
Yes! That's an assist! Ryan Gamer ran Jerry's play there. The hula hoop. That's a Jerry original play there.
Keep your eye on him if you're the opponent because he gets rid of it fast.
And a pass that Ryan learned from his mentor, Sidney Crosby, passing it right off the pads.
So he almost falls, but he's able to get a shot pass. In time. He's able to hold himself up and get that shot off. His hands away from his body, not in the greatest position.
Wait, Taylor Hall beat us in hits? Ryan, that's embarrassing. Can't believe we got beat by Hall in hits by 20. Okay, let's get 20 hits. New plan. I didn't say get hit 20 times, right? Hey, Ryan doesn't have to worry about coaches' trust this game. We can just be completely unhinged. Oh, no. Everybody just got real worried. You mean you haven't been unhinged this entire season, Ryan?
Quick pass to Hall. Here's a chance.
We missed that by a Ryan Gamer amount. That's what Ryan's teammates are starting to call a big miss shot by about 10 feet. They call it a Ryan Gamer shot. So they say, oh, he just Ryan that one. Can you believe that? This team, I tell you, they've been fantastic, but they give Ryan a hard time in practice each week.
Chicago's won the faceoff.
This series has had so many good moments, so many good laughs. One of the most fun on the channel, and honestly, I say one of the most underrated series on this channel. I feel like if everybody watched this series across all my career mode content, I feel like everybody would enjoy it. I really do.
And they take possession after the defensive zone faceoff. On the attack along the boards. Stastlin here in the slot.
He Ryan'd that one. A classic Ryan Gamer right there. Shot it right at the goalie's chest.
Ready to make a save, James. He hasn't been busy this period, but they're in the lead, so it's a safe play. He elects to hold on.
Classic Ryan Gamer.
Swoops in to take possession.
Now, Ryan has actually done a great job. Rookie season in the NHL, rough start, but really turned it around. And true enforcer, but also 77 points. That is amazing as a rookie. That is amazing not as a rookie. Like, that's just amazing in general.
LA's regained possession of the puck. Moves it quickly over to
how amazing was that one, Ryan? Yeah, I deserve that.
And he slides it quickly to Fiala. His best friend on that save right there.
Wow. Okay.
They got thunderstruck on the play. Saucer pass across.
He wouldn't fight me. If you hit me like that, you better be ready to drop the gloves. I can tell you that right now.
He's been a workhorse tonight, James, and there's just another example.
Number 22, I think it was. Or maybe I picked on the wrong guy.
He's on his way down. He's stumbling, and he manages to find the puck and get a shot on net. That's tenacity at its best.
Moves it to Kempe. Chicago's penalty is now expired.
James, we'll leave, but hey, number 22, whoever that was who laid down that hit, you better keep your head on a swivel out there on the ice when you got the puck. I'm mad now. I imagine hitting somebody like that and not fighting. I might have missed who actually hit us. Ryan might have attacked the wrong guy. He took a pretty big hit. You know, that was a big shot. Ryan didn't know where he was after he got hit, so he might have just tried to fight the wrong player.
Trying to get the puck out of harm's way. And the puck is cleared.
Yeah, maybe we definitely do a series for NHL 25 because we're going to miss this. We are going to miss this.
Chicago's still dealing with a one-goal deficit as the power play fails to capitalize.
You can have all the ozone possession time on a power play in the world and you don't convert. Why? Because that's where you have it, on the outside. You have to find ways to create seams.
See, that was the double hula hoop. You know, you never want a double hula hoop. Only the single.
Takes a shot. Oh, what a save.
At least that's what Ryan's shooting coach Jerry says. So blame Jerry. Or I blame Ryan on that one, technically, because Jerry says never double hula hoop.
In the driver's seat, they lead it 2-1 in what has been a very special spirited affair.
I thought we should have scored a goal there, but what do I know?
Chicago's put a lot of pucks on net so far here in this.
We're down 2-1, everybody. 4 minutes and 37 seconds left in the first.
Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Oh, it serves up a little too sweet with that save.
You know, we're a sniper player build, but we don't seem like a sniper.
Los Angeles has been so strong defensively, and they've been putting their opponent in vulnerable positions all night long, but they've got to find a way to, when they intercept, to get going the other way and generate some offense.
Series finale. You got to leave it all out there, Ryan. Ryan, the Punisher gamer. Show him what you've got.
Let's see if one of these stars can give their team the upper hand in this matchup. Back to you now.
Slick feed. And he slides it quickly to Clem Denning. And that caroms off a body in traffic. And the puck's knocked loose.
Beautiful.
Chicago's got possession of the puck. Quick feed to Johnson. LA's grabbed a hold of the puck.
That's not ideal.
Takes the pass. Here they come up along the wing. Taken along the wall by Kaliev. Shot. Takes a shot.
A little extracurricular activity. It's the final game of the year.
I mean, when you have a
battle for 27th place.
You know that you got to find a way to get your glove on it. You got to be fast. You got to be quick and show those reflexes.
Is that a B minus defense? All right. Thanks, coach. Look, coach is like, hey, come back to Chicago in NHL 25, Ryan. All right, coach. We're going to the Penguins.
Hey,
our coach hated Ryan the entire year,
comes
didn't
to an end. One of the all-time great rock acts from the 80s getting set to play here for these fans. And we'll catch our breath. Back with more in a moment.
Okay, let's take a look at these stats. So we had 12 shots in one go. They had 8 shots and 2 goes. They out-hit us 16-8. Ryan, you better wake up. We had more time in attack. We had worse passing. They had 100% passing. Yeah, right. Is that even possible? What? 100% passing in the NHL? I guess when you don't play defense, no, actually B minus defense. So can't blame it on Ryan.
Second frame is underway as the puck is dropped. Well, Cheryl, already a third of this one.
We're trying to win rookie of the year. Come on.
To manage the puck. They've been popping it up all
we got an assist already. We need a couple goals to lock it in.
They need to start talking, know where each other is going to be, and execute on those passes.
The Blackhawks looking against the half wall. Hall's got control of the puck in the corner.
Scores!
And the scratching and clawing has paid off as we are back
okay.
to even.
Well, we're back to that was some of the best really passing like we've shown this entire season.
You're trying to find a way to get ahead and on top.
That was so fast. I'll be honest with you. I didn't even know what was going on. He saucer passed that over Ryan to the defenseman, and he ripped that puck into the back of the net. What? That's how you play hockey right there. All right, coach, what do you need? One last time.
The bench, our young
Ryan, we're putting the pressure on them. Don't stop. All right, coach. I gotcha.
Well, I think this is a reminder that he's doing a real good
job. I think coach secretly loves Ryan Gamer. He'll just never admit it.
Time and the sustained pressure they've had. I think it's really important for a coach
to see him look like, wait, Ryan, that's not what I said. I think Ryan said, okay, 3 fights. And manager was like, no, that's not it, Ryan. You'll see that double take, the look on his face. No, not 3 fights, Ryan. I said keep up the pressure. Oh, 3 fights, coach? One with number 22? I gotcha.
Blackhawks take it along the wall. Breeds it. It's a 2-on-1. Sticks inside.
2-2 hockey game. Series finale. I think we got to do a series for NHL 25. Look, I'm already locked in. I don't know why I grab the shirt like that to show like I'm locked in. What does that even mean? I'm locked in. That's my hockey fighting animation right there. Like,
passes the puck over to Fiala. Big time saving goal as he gets all of it with the stick.
Oh my. Just maybe less replay breakdowns in NHL 24. That's like my most comments I get throughout the older NHL videos. Like, can you stop pausing for a replay every 5 minutes? I'm like, well, you make a point. But also, some of them are hilarious. What a pass.
Ryan.
Uses the stick. Here's a blast. Denies him with a save. Here's a chance. And that's intercepted.
Hit him, Ryan.
Puck dumped in and the forwards are going to skate off. Through the neutral zone and into the offensive end. Here he is on the backhand. And the puck stopper jumps on.
Speaking of an instant replay, y'all want to see the worst move of the year? The worst move of the year, surprisingly, does not go to Ryan Gamer. Very surprising. It goes to Johnson. Watch this incredible play on the transition here. So Ryan takes this down. This may be the final replay breakdown of the season. Ryan dodges the hit. Great skating. Feeds the open man. And Ryan's like, okay, teammates wide open over there, right? Wide open. And then Johnson's like, no, I'm going to do a deke. I'm going to take it between my legs into three defenders, and I'm not going to pass it. It somehow does end up going to our teammate there. But look how open this pass is. There's plenty of open ice. You just feed it down there. Let the teammate over there, number 71, get to it and score a goal. That would have been our second assist of the game. Instead, between the legs into three defenders. Actually, that looks like something Ryan Gamer would have done early rookie, but he didn't know how to deke. So there's a reason Ryan didn't deke very much. He just didn't know how to do it. So he can do it now. He just chooses not to. So yeah, the worst play of the season, the worst deke of the season does not go to Ryan Gamer. It goes to Johnson. So there you have it. On to the next one, right?
Top of it to get a stoppage in play.
And there's your replay breakdown. Brought to you by GamerAbility 2. So get on over there, subscribe to the second channel. Link at the bottom of the description where you might see the NHL 25 series. You never know. B minus across the board. Coach, you're trying to win us back. I get it. All right. The Kings 3-2.
Centers glide into the
Come on, Chicago, wake up.
Ready to resume play.
No, I really am completely undecided on NHL 25 series. I got to think about it. Got to see how next week goes to see if I have time for it, right?
Here's a chance behind the net. Centering pass, and that's stopped.
That's a save of the year. Ryan stole it, but didn't realize that he did, and he went for the hit. Did you see that? The going for the hit allowed the opponent to grab the puck and get a great shot. Anderson is always looking whenever he knows Ryan's playing defense. He knows to always be paying attention because you just never know what Ryan's going to do. Now, I will say, Ryan has became a much better defender across this series. Like, I'm not even joking. We're just making that up. I feel like we've come a long way defensively. We're not great, but we're better.
And he makes himself big, takes away the holes, and makes the save.
Now, granted, that's not very difficult to do better than the way we started, but still.
The Kings have a hold of it in the defensive zone.
Paul, can you quit dancing?
Moves the puck.
And play hockey?
Here's a great use of the stick right there to poke it away. Moves the puck over to Ryan. Chicago's on the attack. Shot! Oh, and a great save by Corpusalo. Denies him again.
You can certainly tell that the goaltender is dialed in on that last sequence of saves, James. He's to position, so he finds a way to make multiple saves back to back.
I really want to see how close that shot was. Let's take another shot.
Lays the body.
Okay, I'll go to the bench, coach.
Played along the boards.
Yeah, let's watch the shot breakdown. Let's not watch that hit. We have to. Let's go do this next shot. What did I say? I don't remember exactly. But look at me trying to do a shot. And then... Okay, number eight. All right. If you're going to hit me like that, you better be ready for a fight. That's not what I wanted to watch back. I want to watch back this shot. Because I think it was close to going in. But I always think it's close to going in, to be fair. It's open. How do we zoom? I should know this. I've done it 1,000 times. How many replay breakdowns have I done? Oh, that's open. Right into the blocker. okay, maybe if we should have shot left. I don't think any of it was open. I don't think it was open at all. There's two defenders to the left. The pass isn't open, so not the worst shooting decision. It got the rebound, and we almost got a goal out of it. Dowdy, number eight, who we will get in a fight with later on, did a great job defending there. So I'm going to pause the video, take a couple screenshots, and we'll win this game. You know, we got to take a look at this. I don't think goalies have any respect for Ryan Gamer's shooting accuracy. Watch the goalie here. Goalie has his eyes open. It looks like he's staring at Ryan, right? He's staring him down like, oh, he's like, watch. You're going to go to shoot. I'm going to close my eyes. The goalie closes his eyes. Look. He closes his eyes. He keeps his eyes shut until halfway and then opens them and saves it. The goalie's out here trick saving on Ryan the Punisher. They're out here trick saving in the final game of the season to play for 27th place. A lot at stake here. Out here trick saving. What a save that was, though. We'll have to give that to him. That was pretty good. I'll close my eyes on the next shot. Go right back at him. Imagine. Oh, I will. 3-0. 2 minutes left. Let's focus up. No eyes closed shots, Ryan. Wake up. Might be the defensive play of the year.
Both sides digging in for that puck along the wall.
Knock him into the glass. Knocked him through the glass. Oh my. Ryan, the Punisher.
Here in the late going of the frame.
Now I might be able to see why people say I do too many replay breakdowns now. I started. Oh. That's what they were referring to. All right, I get it. I'll settle down. But look at this hit. Could be the final hit of the season right through the glass. Are you kidding me? If this was like the older classic, like NHL hits, you could like knock them through the glass. Why didn't nobody fight me for that? You all don't want to fight me when I just hit your player directly into the glass and break it, and you still don't want to fight me? Like, Ryan's trying to get those three fights Coach asked for a little bit ago. Nobody wants to fight us. We're trying. What a hit. And I think us breaking the glass might have saved them from getting a goal. Oh. Another good poke check.
Well, the shooter's in a coveted spot.
Your comments, your all's comments on the series have been so fun as well. You all gave me so many good laughs. You all give me so many good laughs across all the career mode series. Greatly appreciate that. I love your all's comments in the Ryan Gamer universe. It's just so much fun.
Sends the pass over. Second frame almost done. Well inside a minute now. And a stiff.
Good try, Ryan.
And he takes the feed.
Did you all see Ryan just elbow that guy just casually right by the ref? And the ref's like, oh, let him play. Yeah, let him play. I didn't see anything, ref. Oh, number eight.
He's behind him. He's going to be the foundation tonight.
Through center along the wing. Looks like there's a delayed penalty being called.
You're kidding me.
Late in the period, in a close game, a tough penalty to take.
Penalty?
James, but if they can just kill it maybe off and get to the intermission, they can reset to start.
Unsportsmanlike, probably. No fight after he hit us like that earlier. Okay, I can see why that's a penalty. He hit us so hard earlier, and you're telling me he's not going to fight us? Like,
LA's won the draw.
We're trying to put on a show here in the final game. For all of Ryan's fans here in NHL 24 here on YouTube, Daddy. And you just let us down. And yeah, Ryan let his team down, getting in the penalty box there. I understand that.
I know you're fired up for this too.
Oh, I'm fired up, all right. The commentator said he was fired up. I'm fired up. And their passing did go down, but it's a tie hockey game. One more period of hockey in NHL 24. Let's finish big. Come on. Hey, Dowdy, I'm coming for you.
Teams are lined up and they
settle
are
down,
ready
Ryan.
To get this third period underway.
Let's just focus on winning the hockey game. Five on four.
The Kings come up empty-handed on the power play. Both sides back to even strength.
Ryan on the penalty kill. This is a bad idea. Never mind. We're 5-4.
Almost as if they're on a pendulum or a string together, knowing exactly what the other is going to do and the reason they're still tied.
Puck picked up by Kempe.
Ryan came out of the box and dominated defensively. He's mad.
Moves it quickly over to Johnson. Chicago's got a hold of the puck. The Blackhawks play it along the wing. Here's a feed in front.
That was the best pass of the year. A little stutter step. He just barely missed it.
The Blackhawks cross the blue line.
That was the pass of the year.
We'll get a face-off coming up.
As we look at that last save again, James, it is absolutely incredible and so impressive to see a goaltender.
That was an incredible save.
His opponent to find the puck.
Okay.
Lots of time left in this period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Johnson's quick stick lands on the puck here at center. Hall's gonna play it against the half wall.
Oh, sneaky poke check.
By the goaltender as he pokes it away.
That's our third hat trick. I mean, third hat trick, third assist.
James have been closing on the puck quickly. You sense an upward trajectory as this game's progressed and they find the back of the net.
Now, I know what you are thinking. Why did you pass that?
He corrals it on his backhand. That's a great play to get it off quickly.
Can I pretend I tried? And we leave it at that? Can we pretend I tried to pass that to the back of the net right to the teammate and let him kind of...
feeling good about themselves after taking the
lead
with that goal.
Great
here in the
decision
third.
To pass.
Yeah,
I just had a good feeling that we needed to pass that.
Forth, James, but it's something. You're in the lead, so now
definitely did not miss
tempo.
The shot by a mile. That's a penalty.
Back, continue to punch and press.
Definitely did not miss the shot. It was just a classic pass to the left of the net.
A tough penalty to take
teammate,
as you're looking for
the
equalizer. You're in a one-goal deficit, and you got to find a way to generate offense, James. Real tough one to take.
B+. Coach finally loves us. Thanks, Coach. Took us 82 games to get to this point.
They haven't scored on the power play yet. 100% is not a number that you see typically. So they got to find a way to just stay.
What is this, episode 49 of the NHL series, I believe?
We haven't even hit the midway
50, maybe?
Mark of the period. The Blackhawks have
it's
taken the
49
lead.
49 games.
Few
we play
minutes.
That's a lot.
They'd love to build on it. Deep inside his own end, right in front. Can he get out of pressure? Oh,
that's what I'm talking about. Now fight me.
Doughty's moving the puck through
number
his
eight.
Zone. Gaining momentum up along the side. Stopped by the goaltender, getting a piece of that one. Moves it to Hall.
Play's got the puck on his stick now, and you know he's looking for the hat trick, James.
Moves it around along the half wall. From the point, takes a shot. Korpisalo's gonna hang on for a whistle.
Tried to get the fight there for
teams
you all. I'm trying out there.
Drop.
Imagine us playing, or I feel like we're playing our most emotional game yet. Focusing on enforcing, but it turns out to be one of our best games across the board. B+ everywhere. You know, how three assists is not an A+ on the stat sheet amazes me. 4-3 hockey game, 10 minutes left in Riot Gamer's NHL 24 career. It all comes down to this, a 3-point night. That was a weak shot.
Anderson's gonna opt for the whistle. I don't mind this call here in the third.
Neither do I. Listen, he has been so dialed in all night, James. He has been excellent, arguably their best player. And he's trying to preserve the lead here by holding on to this one to get the faceoff.
That's a smart read with the two centermen tied up. Answered the call there.
Number eight, you want
to
go? Hey, I'm ready right now. Oh, he wouldn't drop him again. I tell you, number eight.
Past the midway mark of the frame. Fans have okay. been treated to a fun one tonight. Lots of offense. It's 4-3.
Come on, Kings. Put on a show for your fans.
Los Angeles has the puck in their own end.
Kopitar has been so effective at the draw tonight. He's been out-dueling his opponent and winning every matchup.
The Blackhawks carried along the wall. Quick feed to Jones. Flips it up to net.
Oh, what a save on the play! Wow!
Oh, that's grand larceny, James. I mean, he just stole one away from his
Coach,
opponent.
Coach, I don't want to leave.
Play continues here, but this crowd still buzzing after what we saw. What a stop that was.
Come on, Coach. Let him play. 8 minutes left in his NHL career. Let Ryan Gamer play.
It's a nice feeling. Why? Because it doesn't always go this way. So when you have it, you embrace it.
What? You let him play? You didn't let him play the whole last 8 minutes?
60 minutes played,
and they scored overtime.
Not all heroes wear capes. Some of them have skates. We'll find out who the hero is next.
Not all heroes wear capes. Some of them wear skates, the announcer said. So here, you all realize we can get our first shootout as well. Everybody remain calm. I'm not hoping we don't score, but I would not be upset if no team scores and we go to our first penalty shootout. We better lock it down defensively. Remember I said this after we allow the first goal. What is our coach feedback? B+. One of our best games yet for the end. And I feel like I've been doing crazy stuff. What coach does not have the leading scorer on the ice for the last 8 minutes of the game? That's insane. Leading points and goal scorer, I think, on this team. Definitely assist. All right, here we go.
Ready to get it underway.
What a season finale. What a series finale.
All the action. It's overtime. Turn that chance aside.
Settle down.
And now he moves it quickly to Jones.
Settle down.
Picks up the puck in his own end. The Blackhawks pick up steam and are on the attack. Spectacular stop by the goalkeeper.
We almost snuck it in there.
Chicago's got possession here in the offensive zone.
I'm on, no!
Taken
get
by
back!
Biela, trying to gain
get
depth.
Back!
All alone!
We checked him!
Oh, what a defensive play!
Get up, goalie!
And that's off a stick. The Black
that's
Hunter,
our poke
he's
check.
He's clear! We got a whistle as the puck goes out of play.
He Ryan'd it. Sent it 10 feet over the net.
Such an impressive save. Love looking at this one again, James. You know that this goaltender is
he saved
in,
it.
So focused.
Right? I don't. I think he gloved it. What a poke check from Ryan. I love hockey so much. I'm telling you. Coach, no.
This offensive zone face-off.
Oh, you can't play the whole game? A minus, B plus, A minus. A minus defense? I'm going to retire from NHL.
Nice job tying up his opponent.
Yeah, this will be the last episode ever of NHL.
No room for that
team, please lock it down. Don't you dare. No, dude, that was the worst defense I've ever seen. You can't make this stuff up. You know, Ryan almost scored twice in the overtime. Played some of the best defense he's ever played. And our defenseman played the worst defensive play of the year. That was worse than Ryan Gamer this entire season. We've had some bad defensive plays. We've never played that bad. I do not know what our defender was doing. That was perfect, Ryan. Thanks, Coach. Thanks. Has to be enough to win Rookie of the Year. That was an incredible finale. I can't believe we lost. We almost had our first shootout, too. Well, I say almost. There's 3 minutes left, but... Wow. Hey, Ryan left it all out there. Left it all out there. This Chicago team left it all out there as well. No fights. They would not fight, Ryan. Did you see that? They're like, no, it's the final game of the season. We're not going to fight. Get out of here, Ryan. That's what they were saying. Isn't this your final game or something, Ryan? I thought we had... Did I add another assist there? I kept saying three assists. You all were like, Ryan, did you just make up one? Yeah. I clearly did. I thought we had three assists. But we had a plus three on plus minus. That's amazing. Shooting percentage continues to improve. We had plenty. We had some good shot opportunities. We had some good hits too. Five hits. A no fights one though. That's unfortunate. I really wanted to fight. The most unfortunate part is that we lost though. But coach did not have us in the entire last 8 minutes of the third period. We're the leading scorer on this team. Like, I just don't get that. A minus overall. D plus offense. A minus defense. B plus team play. Can we take a picture of this and never forget that we just got an A minus defensive game in our final game of the season? So clearly the amount of heart that I had today in hitting the other team, it allowed me to play better defense overall. I was just full sending it every time. That is a heartbreaking loss though. Can we watch that terrible defensive play? Yes, we can. Okay, good, good. You all ready? What? This, keep in mind. Wait, where's our, who's our, that is our defenseman. Jones is defenseman. But Jones is shooting, right? So watch. Jones shoots. Jones needs to get back. He doesn't. So then number 70 is covering for him. So watch this cover. It's 3-on-3. You're going to go for the hit there. When number 9 is coming over, you got no help. That is the worst AI defensive decision that we've seen this entire season. And we've seen some pretty bad ones. You can't do that. You skate with number 9. Instead, he gives up an easy breakaway goal. You can't make this stuff up. Like, poor Anderson. Poor Anderson this entire season, honestly. Because this sums up, if you're just jumping into this NHL series, you wonder how this Chicago team was. This play right here sums up our entire season. Does it not? If you watch the series, this sums up our entire defense. Our entire season. The worst decisions you ever see. Now, some of you might say, well, Ryan would have done the same thing. No, I don't think he would, actually. I don't think he would. There's no way. I would never go. I go for hits a lot. But if I'm in a... I know my teammates are up there. I've got to skate back with number 9. You have to. It's... You know, at least we can give it to him. He made up his mind and he full sent it. You know, at least when you make your decision, even if it's the wrong one, at least you full send it to try to make a play on the puck. I am blown away with that decision right there. Coach should have never took Ryan off the ice. And wow, what a goal. And Anderson, I mean, that you can't blame Anderson on that one. That should have never have been a breakaway. That is a heartbreaking way to finish this season. That just sums up this team season right there. It just so many heartbreaking moments in one series on the channel. Like, you go through and you binge watch this series. You're going to see highs. You're going to see lows. Mostly you're going to see lows because of poor defensive play. Just like that. Ryan was a part of that poor defensive play a lot. We have to say it like it is. I thought we had three assists that game. We did not, but what a game. What a way to finish. And we got a skill point. You love to see it. Continue simming. Regular season has ended. We finished 80 overall as a rookie. 79 points. Did we win? Did we win? Let's go to the Stats Central, right? Did we win the award we want? We will not win the Stanley Cup. I can tell you that. Oh, I bet it hasn't been. Yeah, it hasn't been announced yet. Okay. That's right, because it's not technically over. So let's take a look at the season stats, right? Here we go. Ryan Gamer led the team in goals. Yes, we did. Led the team in goals. Played all 82 games. Did not lead the team in assists. So we led the team in goals. We did not lead the team in assists. That was our defenseman, Seth Jones, who won a couple games in overtime, if you remember. Now, did we lead our team in points? We had to have. Yes, 79. Led our points as our team in points as a rookie by 10. Plus minus stat? We don't look at that one. Did we lean in it? Yeah. So that's, I play a lot of golf on the channel. Minus is good, right? Minus 23. That means we did not allow 23 goals. I'm just kidding. I know exactly what that stat means. And you want it in the positive. So yeah, okay, moving on. Penalty minutes, I'm going to say yes, we led. Yeah. Yes! Ryan! The Punisher! Gamer! 206 penalty minutes. A lot from fights. Shots 429. I mean, honestly, considering we shot 429 times, a 7.7 shooting percentage is amazing. Right? Ryan, do you ever consider passing? No. Yes, we did it at least 46 times and led our team. But wow, we shot a lot too. That just shows a lot. How many of those hit the net? Isn't a shot only classified as a shot if it's a shot on goal, or is that not... Right? Doesn't it have to be on net, or does it not? A game-winning goes, 6. Did we lead our team in that? Yes, we did. Led our team in game-winning goes. Power play goes. Did we lead our team in that? And we were barely on the power play. We were number 3. We barely got to play on the power play. Power play points. We were 14. Down 3. Okay. Paul got that. Shorthanded goes. I don't think we had one, did we? Yeah, we did not. Well, obviously. We were never on the ice on shorthanded. You don't, if you get a negative 23 plus minus, you're not going to be on the shorthanded team, surprisingly. Time on ice per game. Listen. Your first line right winger should play more than 18 minutes, in my opinion. We should play 20. Just like Johnson and Hall. Well, never mind, though. The 18's about right, right? Because we're not shorthanded, and we weren't on the power play. Never mind. Forget what I just said. That's actually probably fair. 18 is actually fair. So forget everything I just said. Now, face-offs won. We don't have to worry about that. What about hits? Here we go. We did not lead. Taylor Hall led with 271. We got 257, and that's going to be first and second in the NHL. Blocked shots, we got 27. Look at our defenseman. Right D. 135. Giveaways. Yeah, a giveaway to your teammates, right? Yeah. Yeah, that's those passes, right? Those giveaways. Definitely not referring to giveaways as turnovers. Some stats are best not looked at the end of a career. And giveaways is one of them. We made a lot of mistakes. Like, hey, I don't claim to be the best NHL player out there in the world. Did we greatly improve? Yes. Are we a solid player? Yes. Do we always play our position? No. Do we do crazy stuff? Yes. And when you do crazy stuff, you get 252 giveaways. What about takeaways? 84. Where were we on that list? Number 4. Fights, here we go, 28, baby. Yes, we tried to make that 31, but the LA Kings were not having it. Nobody wants to mess with Ryan, the Punisher, the legend, Lee, the gamer. Ryan took so many shots in his NHL career, he forgot his full name. Ryan Lee, the legend, the Punisher, Sixpenny, Gamer. Wow. If we get another name from another sports game, we're in trouble. I'm never going to remember it. Now, what about fights won? What? You don't care about fights won, coach? First round draft pick, first pick. Love to see it. What about fights won? You're kidding. Is it shown here? Wait, where's fights won? You tell me you don't keep track of that, coach? No fights won? Full career stats? What about fights won? No fights won? Do they not care about that? Wait, you don't care about fights won, coach? I can't believe that's not a stat here in this game. You know, 28 fights. How many did we win? Does anybody know? I feel like we had to win half of them. I'd say even like 70%. We'll never know. We will never know. So now awards, we'll find out. Should we look at Connor Bedard? Hey, let's look how Connor Bedard did, actually. Let's look at the Ducks. All right, where's Bedard? Wasn't he on the Ducks? Wait, did I make that up? Was he on San Jose? He was drafted by another team. It's been a while since I've looked at him. Did he get drafted to San Jose? Yeah, he did. Okay. So he had 64. We beat him. He had 64 hits and we had minus 23. He had one. Minus 23 is clearly better, right? We had more shots. His shooting percentage was a lot better. I still think Chicago would be happy they got Ryan Gamer over Connor Bedard. I really do. I really think that they're proud. Did he get in any fights, though? One fight. Was it? Wait, that was... I remember. That was Ryan being a bully. I remember that. Do you all remember that fight? Connor Bedard didn't want to fight, and Ryan Gamer just kept hitting the button there at the end of the game. But remember, Connor Bedard said something. Ryan Gamer still claims that Connor Bedard, he was saying something to Ryan, said something really bad. We don't know what he said to Ryan, but yeah. Hey, who has a better fight win percent? Ryan Gamer or Connor Bedard? Ryan Gamer. He only had 9 penalty minutes? You're kidding. 9 in 82 games? How's that even possible to be that disciplined? We had more goals and assists, and that's what matters, right? And we had more fights won. Fights improve your team's morale. They get your team fired up. They improve your team's stamina when you win. It's key. It is a very key thing. So what happens next? Advance the day. What about the awards? Why does the teammate want to have a conversation? Wait, the season, what is this? I expected more from you, Ryan. Lackluster defense is partly why we're at the bottom of the standings? Excuse me, Anderson? Excuse me? I've heard that before. We need better results next season. Listen here, Anderson. You're talking to the wrong player. Whatever you say, Ryan says. Okay. Anderson stepped over the line there. Anderson's getting mad at Ryan. We did not lose the game for us. Did that say he wanted Ryan to have an A defense? Look how mad Anderson is. And look, now gives us a fist bump. Okay. All right. Ryan was not great at defense, but we're not a defenseman, right? We're not supposed to be the best defender. Regular season has ended. So is this when we can look at awards? When can we look at awards? Do we not look at that till the next season? Did we win Rookie of the Year? The Cotter Memorial Trophy. We don't know yet. Okay. Anderson has the nerve to get mad at Ryan. Like, that was our best defensive game. We've seen it all, right? NHL season is complete. Stop simulation. Yes. Who won? Well, we'll see who won the Stanley Cup. What's going to be the next big event, though? Is this going to allow us to actually see the awards? Please let us see the awards. Don't let us go this far without seeing them. Okay, playoffs are complete. The Dallas Stars are the Stanley Cup champions. Calder Cup champion. Oh, okay, Calder Cup champions. Okay, Toronto Marlies. I thought that said the... Okay, never mind.
awards.
Yes, Ryan, the Punisher Gamer is your rookie of the year. Potter Memorial Trophy, another trophy for the trophy cabinet here on the Gamerability YouTube channel. He fought for that, and I mean literally he fought for that 28 times, right? That fight against Connor Bedard might have sold the deal. You know, that might have been a key fight in the voting for this trophy. Let's go. That is massive. Let's go, baby. You're Rookie of the Year. Look at this. Let's go, Ryan. We better get to take that trophy home, right? We better get to take it home. End of rookie season. We did it. First goal on 10-11, 2023.
46 assists.
46 assists.
More than 70 points. And the Calder Trophy.
I didn't notice somebody was talking in the background. I was too excited. Yes. Chicago does not have a great season, but we fought. We fought till the end. Ryan didn't get a fight in that last game, but hey, that was awesome. Thank you all so much for the support on this season. Your Rookie of the Year of the 2024 season is Ryan Lee, the legend, the Punisher, Sixpenny Gamer. He left it all out there on the ice. 79 points in 82 games. 80 overall as a rookie now. And we get to close out this series on a high note, winning Rookie of the Year. Now, I know the big question is, what could Ryan Gamer and this Chicago Blackhawks team could they have done in another season? And I'm just going to go out on a limb and say they want to win a Stanley Cup, and I'm just going to stick to that. We may never know what happens, but I do believe this team is going to win the Stanley Cup next season. So I will see you all in the next Career Mode episode on the channel. There's tons of other series to tune into and maybe a new one for NHL 25. I'm not sure yet. I haven't made any decisions. I'm kind of leaning towards maybe not doing one, but also this kind of got me fired up into doing one. So I don't know what I'm going to do. As of now, I would say likely I might not do a new series for NHL 25 because I just have so many series going on right now that I'm really enjoying and having a good time with. And yeah, this one is so entertaining. It's going to be hard to follow this one up. It's just so much fun. So many fun moments, so many good laughs. It's going to be hard to follow this one up with another one, right? But who knows? Maybe on the right team, maybe the Pittsburgh Penguins or something. It could work out. But yeah, I don't know. I'm undecided. Right now, I'm leaning towards no, but we will see. We will see. But be sure to drop a like if you got some enjoyment. It really helps the channel. Subscribe for more and check the different playlists in the video description below. That's the best place to look for more episodes Look, it's over, Ryan. What are you talking about? To check for other Career Mode series. But I greatly appreciate all the support and I will see you all in the next video on the channel. As always, have a fantastic day, everybody. My dogs are saying bye. They're saying bye, everybody. Bye, YouTube.